the death penalty is being touted as a tool that is going to aid and assist police officers, right? That's one of the arguments, is that you kill a police officer, we will kill you.
I've had lots of interaction with individuals who have been sentenced to very long periods of time, 25 to life, and life without parole. And I've never had any of them say to me that if I had known I could face the death penalty, I wouldn't have done it.
Nobody stops and says to somebody before they commit a murder, remember now, capital punishment is a factor that's in this state that you're going to be exposed to. They have to have that knowledge, and they have to draw upon that knowledge in the midst of a situation where they are so either angry, violent, desperate, whatever that the case might be, that's going to overshadow their emotions.
I don't imagine a criminal sitting back thinking, oh, wait, I need to stop this. I may face a death penalty. I just don't think that's realistic. I mean, I think a lot of this is planned out or not. I think if someone's going to go ahead with it, they're thinking, I'm going to get away with it.
And so the whole premise of it is that an informed criminal population will make rational choices. If they were going to make rational choices, they wouldn't be committing the crime. They don't think they're going to be caught. I mean, that's reality. So why do we deny that? Why do we pretend like that's not true?
I understand where policymakers are coming from. They're seeing this as a stance of supporting the law enforcement professional who is out protecting society. And therefore, that's how I think it's being played or spun to the law enforcement community is, look, we're taking care of you should this occur. However, I think that's hollow, and I don't think that's a sound, civilized way of approaching this.
When you look at New Hampshire itself, if you believe that our death penalty in the state actually deters criminals, then you have to ignore what happened in Franconia, New Hampshire. You have to ignore what happened in Greenland, New Hampshire. You have to ignore what happened in Brentwood. In all my years of law enforcement, what I have learned is most criminals are impulsive. They don't sit there and weigh the options before they commit a crime.
Those that say that the death penalty increases the level of safety, I think frequently don't examine the information that's out there.
And of course, one of the things you could do is you could look at the homicide rate for all the states that did not have capital punishment and those that did. And it turned out there was a very clear pattern. The states that did not have capital punishment, without exception, had lower murder rates than the average of those states that did have capital punishment.
I believe years ago that maybe the death penalty deterred violent crime, that who would possibly commit a violent crime if death was a penalty? And then I realized that Texas has killed about 12 people a year in their death chambers for the last 40 years, and Texas has a pretty high crime rate.
So if deterrence isn't meaningful, for which there is no support other than opinion, then that, again, in my view, undermines the validity of it.
Because if the goal is to deter them, it's not working. Just go to Texas and find out.